garlic pepper steak. Got seasoning, cheese, sauce, mashed potatoes, and the nested tray, and the steak. Trying to do these a little faster. So, separate the aluminum trays, remove the plastic from the potatoes. They're like squished up to one side. I don't think that really matters. Flatten the potatoes into an even layer. Oh, I guess it does matter. They anticipated it getting unsettled, I guess. And it went everywhere. Cool. Okay. Parmesan on top of the potatoes. Decent amount of cheese. Okay. Open the steak, put it in the tray, put the steak seasoning on top of the steak. Can do. And then the house sauce I can do at the end as an optional thing. So we're gonna put these in here. Scan. And I want the less done. 15 minutes, start. 400 degrees, bake. And there it goes. Doop doop boodle doop. Okay. Let's get all the station set up here. That smells really good. Get that closed up. All right, now. Remove both trays. Let the steak rest in its tray for 2 to 4 minutes. Transfer the steak and potatoes to a plate. Optional, drizzle the house steak sauce on it after you recombine. I'm gonna try it without it. Now we gotta wait 4 minutes. All right, the 4 minute rest period is done. I'm going to sample mm. mistake. It looks... Well, I'm on the end, but it looks kind of overdone. It's kind of like the steak before. Seasoning's good, but sort of rubbery. I'm gonna have to figure out how to make steak in this thing. I think the automatic instructions aren't quite there. Let's try these taters. Cheesy taters. Hot. Weird. They're underdone. I can feel the chewiness of like almost a raw potato in my head. I'd probably get this one again, but I might try to tweak the timings manually. It's all right.